Hi everyone, in this video we will look at creating a data stream with AWS Kinesis. So first we'll go ahead and search for it in the services bar. Data streams are becoming really popular. It allows you to actually capture data in near real time. So let's start here. We'll go ahead and click create data stream. And like everything else, the first thing we'll do is give it a name. I'll call it my demo stream. We'll set the number of shards, which is really the throughput that it's going to allow. We're going to keep it at 1 so that for the sake of the demo, it will reach that throughput quicker and we can see results. So now let's take a look here. It's now given an ARN. We can monitor it. So once we start to push data through, we can monitor it. So what we are actually going to do for this demo is create an application, a Python application that's going to just consistently push dummy data to our stream from our local environment. Assuming you have Python already installed, the first thing you need to do for this is install the required AWS package, which is BOTO3, B-O-T-O-3. I already have a Python file saved here that I'm going to use. I'll provide this in a GitHub link for you to use as well. And basically it's just going to go through and loop through 1,000 times and say, hello world. We need to put the name of our stream here. And you can just see it's doing is using this put record function to push a piece of data that just says hello world to our stream. Let's go into this file and try to run it. Python kinesis.py, that's the name of our file. And it should error here. Right, so it's saying you must specify a region. There are certain defaults that are not configured here. It's basically saying, you know, we recognize what you're trying to do, but we don't have any idea where you want to put this or what username to log in as, etc. To handle this, we will go to our user account and create a .aws folder that's going to hold our configuration and credentials. So .aws. We'll navigate to this folder and create these two files. One is config with no file type, just blank. And the next will be credentials, also with no file type. So what do we put in here? For config, this is going to be where we say, which region do we want? This is where it's going to look for that. So we'll type region equals, in our case, we're creating this stream on US East 2. So we'll put that here, and this would be wherever you are creating yours, wherever your account is based. And in credentials, also write in default, and we'll need to say our user credentials, our account credentials, so it's able to log in. And the name of these variables are AWS Access Key ID, as well as AWS Secret Access Key. And to find this, you actually need to create this in your account. So if you go under your account information and select My Security Credentials, there will be a section here to create access key. And this is what we want. So go ahead and click this. Obviously, I'm going to delete mine after I do this. Go ahead and copy your access key as it shows there. And then also your secret key. Again, this is mine. You can't use these. You'll create your own. And I'm going to remove these after this video. So we're all set here. Now let's try this Python script one more time. And it should now recognize the credentials. And it's working. Here we can see it's consistently looping through and just pushing data, that hello world text, to our stream. So let's hop back in and see if we can monitor this and see the data coming through. Select monitoring. It may need a second to process. We'll refresh a few times. Okay. A little something. So it looks like it's recognizing it. It may just be a couple seconds behind on everything coming through. There we go. Now we're really able to see it in the monitoring, which is great. So it will continue to push this through. So this data from our local script is getting pushed up through to our stream. And the next step, which we will handle in the next video, is now using this data that's in the stream and putting it somewhere else. In our case, we will take a look at using Kinesis data firehose, which will allow us to take the data from this stream and land it into an S3 bucket. So thanks for watching. Hope you found this helpful, and we'll see you at the next video.